I got into anime by watching Dragon Ball Z. You know, there's so many animes out there, and a lot of them are, you know, based on mixed martial arts like Bakihama, the TIE Fighter, Dragon Ball Z. The list just goes on. You see these Z fighters, you know, Goku, Krillin, Yamcha, they're always training for their next opponent, right? And that's kind of like the story of my life. Subtitles. I refuse to watch anime in English. You can feel the passion for the Japanese actors, the voice actors, come through. Top five, man. So I will say number five would have to go Parasite. This parasite comes to Earth, multiple of them. The parasite gets inside the body and it goes to the brain and controls the human, its host. And one of the parasites ends up getting in one of the humans' arms and doesn't make it to the head. And they become teammates. And pretty much the story goes about Seiichi trying to eradicate all the other parasites. So for me, that's a good one. Not just the animation, but the storyline, and also the soundtrack to Parasite was pretty amazing. Oh man, there's just so many good ones. I'll go to Attack on Titan. It kind of started out like, man, who are these Titans? Where do they come from? It kind of had like a good storyline behind it. And then to come to find out, the manga just finished. The anime is right behind the manga. And to figure out why did Eren do this? What does the Founding Titan do? The Tag Titan do? Amazing storyline about them trying to eradicate the Titans. I'm gonna go with Demon Slayer. I think Demon Slayer is pretty damn amazing. They just got done with the Entertainment District. And that was a straight fire. The very last fight was amazing. The Swordsman's Art District, which I'm looking forward to that one as well. So number two would be Jujutsu Kaisen. This one just came out. What I love about that one is it's a little bit dark and it's all based around the person's skill set. And you have your main character, Itadori, who generates his power through his fist. You have Goju, who's one in a lifetime. His powers come from his eye. But the fight sequence in that is absolutely amazing. And, you know, the story's still coming unfold, and it's about who's the strongest, how you become stronger. The one top anime for your boy will have to be Berserk. It starts out where you have this gentleman by the name Guts, where he's kind of a mercenary. He takes jobs to make money. And you have another guy named Griffith who runs the Bands of the Hawk. And these two meet each other. And it's kind of like a story between like a bromance. It opens your mind to a totally different world that's actually going on. The manga finished and the creator just passed away. And they've talked about picking that back up, but we don't know where it's at right now. But that's my favorite anime. It's very dark, very, very gory. And it just like, there's a part in the show that's like, what? Am I watching the same anime? What is going on here? Obviously you guys are like,
I can't believe you didn't list Dragon Ball Z.
The reason why I didn't list Dragon Ball Z, because I feel Dragon Ball Z is beyond the top five. I think Dragon Ball Z is its own category. I think that's the gateway into anime. Here's Vegeta. They actually did a lot of shading and making it a little more realistic. And then I also have Super Saiyan Gohan 2. I believe this is from the Cell Saga when he first went Super Saiyan 2. He also went Super Saiyan 2 in the Bojack movie. If you guys ever watched the Dragon Ball Z movies, there's 1 through 12, which are really damn good if you guys haven't watched it.